Sapagkat ngayon ika'y pinili isang bayan, isang lipi, isang Diyos, isang hari, bayan umawi. Napapuri, bayan umawi, napapuri.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge that we are all sinners in need of God's mercy as we prepare for this Eucharistic celebration. You came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, Creator and Ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy, grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts. But I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. Love is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interest. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. If there are prophecies, they will be brought to nothing. If tongues, they will cease. If knowledge, it will be brought to nothing. For we know partially, and we prophesy partially, but when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I used to talk as a child, think as a child, reason as a child. When I became a man, I put aside childish things. At present, we see indistinctly as in a mirror, but then face to face. At present, I know partially, then I shall know fully, so I am fully known. So faith, hope, love remain, these three, but the greatest of these is love. the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be His own.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be His own.
Give thanks to the Lord on the harp. With the 10-stringed lyre, chant the praises. Sing to Him a new song. Pluck the strings skillfully with shouts of gladness.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be His own.
For upright is the word of the Lord, and all His works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be His own.
Blessed the nation whose God is the Lord, the people He has chosen for His own inheritance. May Your kindness, O Lord, be upon us who have put our hope in You.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be His own. Please stand.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. I wait for the Lord, my soul waits for His word. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, "To what shall I compare the people of this generation? What are they like? They are like children who sit in the marketplace and call to one another, 'We played the flute for you, but you did not dance. We sang a dirge, but you did not weep.' For John the Baptist came neither eating food nor drinking wine, and you said, 'He is possessed by a demon.' The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and you said, 'Look, he is a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners.' But wisdom is vindicated by all her children." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
A pleasant evening, morning to all of you.
Good morning po.
One of the lessons that I learned in my life as a priest is you cannot please everybody. There will always be people who will criticize you, say something about what you do, or say something about what you are not doing. It is dumb if you do, dumb if you don't situation. Sa Tagalog, sala sa init, sala sa lamig. I think that is one of the situations Jesus confronted during His lifetime. People are never satisfied. They are hard to please. When John the Baptist came not eating, they said he is crazy. When Jesus came eating, they say he is a glutton. Whatever we do, there will always be people that will find fault. There will always be criticisms. But the other lesson that I learned also in the priesthood is this. Not only that there will be people hard to please, but you have to do the right thing. Jesus did the right thing. Jesus did the will of God. He was not concerned about pleasing people. He was concerned about pleasing God. Kaya kung merong mga tao na pupunahin ang ating ginagawa, misan sisiraan pa tayo, huwag nyo nalang pansinin. Ipagdasal nyo, pero gawin nyo kung ano ang nararapat. Sa opisina, sa trabaho, sa community, di ba may mga ganyan tao? Walang hinihintay kundi ikaw ay magkamali at punahin. Walang hinihintay kundi tignan kung ano yung ginagawa mo at punahin. Sometimes we are threatened by that. And we say to ourselves, hindi na lang ako gagawa. Wala na lang akong gagawin. Magkukulong na lang ako sa kwarto. Bahala kayo sa buhay niyo. That does not solve the problem because you may make them, your critique, successful. And so, the Lord did what He was supposed to do because what is important is He pleases the Father. He follows the Father. Let us do the right thing. Or in the words of the first reading, let us love. Because when we love, we will always do the right thing. Amen.
Please stand.
The coming of our Redeemer was foretold by the prophets. By preaching repentance for sins, John the Baptist heralded his coming. In the spirit of penance, let us ask God's help through our prayers as we say, Friend of sinners, gather us in your love.
Friend of sinners, gather us in your love.
That the church on earth may continue to thrive and draw more faithful to the feast of the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Friend of sinners, gather us in your love.
That the rich and the poor alike may not make excuses to evade the call of the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Friend of sinners, gather us in your love.
That we may respond to the call for repentance with sincerity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Friend of sinners, gather us in your love.
That all of us may be committed to the cause of the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Friend of sinners, gather us in your love.
That the dead may live in the house of the Lord and rejoice in the banquet of eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Friend of sinners, gather us in your love.
Heavenly Father, you invite us to be with you in your kingdom. As we pray for others, help us to bring them with us to that banquet set forth by your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these, your servants' offerings, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith. And His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Ang Panginoon ang aking pastol. pinagiginhawa ko. Lubos ang Panginoon ang aking pastol, pinagiginhawa ko.
Please stand.
Let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects, and not our own desires, may always prevail in us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Tonight at 9 p.m., we will have again our regular Wednesday family rosary, and we will be led by the community of the Archdiocesan Shrine of St. Joseph or San Jose de Troso Parish. So let us join in our Wednesday family rosary via Facebook page of the Manila Cathedral at 9 p.m. Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
1, 2, 3. Pinagpalang nilikha. Ipinagliling walang sala. Pusong dalisay dakila, Maria, ina ng